Thunder Bay ghost hovering in the corner. This story taken from Matty. In spring of 2014, I went to visit my friend who had recently moved into a new place. She shared a three-story house with two friends on Crown Street near the Hillcrest Park stairs. Thunder Bay is full of old character homes, so nothing really stood out to me initially. It was the afternoon, and she was in the midst of unpacking, so her stuff was already in her allotted basement space. We were listening to some tunes and chatting away with our mutual friend. After about an hour of hanging out, I noticed my energy level started to dip. It was similar to that of having low blood sugar or being exhausted from a long day of work. I brushed it off as nothing and continued helping her set up her electronics. About 2 or 3 minutes later, I heard this low, static, faint humming sound, and there was an unusual pressure on the side of my forehead. After touching my temple, out of nowhere, I was hit with a powerful wave of energy which ran up my back and down my shoulders, almost as if someone gently grazed the tips of their nails on my skin. I don't know how else to explain this, but I felt the energy leave my presence and move to the next room. Even typing this is starting to creep me out a bit. Without hesitation, I got up and walked towards the room. Immediately when I entered, I was hit with that same sensation again. Only I felt it cover my whole body. Even my toes, hairs were standing up. My eyes were drawn immediately to the top corner of the room, adjacent to the basement stairs. There was a small gray-green mass about the size of a bowling ball that initially looked like a shadow. But after inspecting it closer, I realized it was hovering in front of the wall. After about 3 seconds, it then faced slowly into the wall. I was completely astonished and spent a minute staring at the same spot and compartmentalizing everything. The room was well lit, and there were no windows to cast a shadow from outside. Freaked out, I went outside for smoke. My friend's roommate pulled in the driveway, and before introducing myself, I said, "I know this might sound weird, but your place is definitely haunted." Instead of getting the expected response, they gasped and shared with me stories of music being played on the piano by itself and cupboard doors opening on their own. They were extremely excited to hear this random dude validate their experience. I don't consider myself a skeptic, but I try my best to rule out everything before jumping to the conclusions. The presence didn't necessarily make me feel afraid, but the energy that encapsulated it was strong and grounded. To this day, after years of urban traverses and visiting abandoned asylums and hospitals, I have never quite felt anything like I did in that house.